Love is but a song we sing. Fear's the way we die. You can make the mountains ring or make the angels cry. Though the bird is on the wing and you may not know why. Come on, people now, smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Some may go, he will surely pay his. When the one that left us yet returns for us at last, we are but a moment's sunlight fading in the grass.
Greetings from the First Presbyterian Church of Santa Rosa, California. Please join us today at our second Sunday service on May 10, 1998, Mother's Day. Thus, there was included a special portion of the service, A Personal Reflection of a Mother by Marjorie Stiffler.
From the very first moments when a mother looks at her newborn, this little 5 to 10 pound bit of humanity, she realizes that she, more than anyone else in the world, is responsible for raising this infant to develop the special talents endowed in him by our Creator. She will be the primary guide of the early years, but she knows that after about 20 years, she won't be a major player in his life or her life. So she has to learn to love and let go, which is akin to God's way. For God loves us as his own, and yet he leaves us free to choose to be or not to be in a relationship with him. A mother who acknowledges that Jesus Christ is her Lord and Savior once longs for her child to know this protector who promises to be with her always, with him always, as a guide and counsel who never leaves him, who loves him even when he doesn't love himself. A mother longs for that grounding, the blessed assurance that our children sing so sweetly when they sing, "Jesus loves me," as we listen in awe. The children's lesson is the high point of the service for this mother. Our sanctuary glows with the blessedness of our little children. After that grounding, a mother loves to see that her kids are reaching out for life's gifts and challenges as they become aware of their special talents that God has placed in them. It's a joy to see our kids exercising their minds, their bodies, and their souls, not necessarily in that order. This mother loves to see her children showing love of little ones. This shows that our children have gone beyond the me stage and have learned to put others' needs before their own. This is so meaningful to me because it shows that they have absorbed the two of the main lessons that I've tried to teach, of compassion and of unselfishness. Someone has said that having children is our last, best chance to grow up. Maybe that's because when we have children, we try so hard to instill in these little ones the valuable lessons that we think will help them live a meaningful life. And as any teacher knows, when you try to teach, you become the best learner. So this mother loves to see that her kids like to coach the baseball team, soccer team, get involved in the school activities, help their kids with homework, so that their kids' needs take precedence over their own adult needs. This mother loves to hear that her son is giving up a personal vacation because he's the coach of his daughter's baseball team. And this mother loves to see that her children appreciate the beauty and the bounty of this wonderful area we live in. She loves to see that they acknowledge the legacy of Luther Burbank by planting seeds and watching them grow into lush tomatoes, peppers, squashes, whatever. And it's great to see the hands that plant these vegetables, care for them, and eventually pick them and bring them proudly into the kitchen. These simple pleasures are often the very best, like the joy of preparing food with those we love. This mother counts it a very special blessing to have sons who like to cook special things, like the frugal gourmet's thought that a dinner, being communal, can be to us Christians a true communion when it begins with prayer. When my kids present me with new ideas that challenge me, I cheer. And when they disagree with my too easily expressed old fogey notions, I may manage to cheer quietly later. It's humbling when I hear myself being judgmental and an adult son makes forgiving allowances for someone, showing true compassion. I think that if we could see into the souls of others, we would all find sorrows that would make us cry. But because we are so limited and because we couldn't stand it, we are blessed to be in families where we can share the hurts as well as the joys. When one of my 5 sons is deeply hurt, when the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune pummel, then the troops rally together, everyone sacrificing his own needs to help the one in distress. When such things happen, I recall a marvelous poster from Catholic Charities that shows a young boy of about 14 carrying on his back a younger boy, slightly younger. And someone's query about this heavy load brings the response printed on the poster, "He ain't heavy, he's my brother." In closing, I want to recall a thought on mother love from Eric Fromm's book, The Art of Loving. He says all other kinds of love begin with two separate people coming together in a loving relationship. But mother love starts as a oneness and ends in complete apartness. This little poem encapsulates that thought. Love, 'tis said, is one and one, another oneness make. Mother love cannot be so, though from oneness came, fulfills itself in twain.